Loving is a flow style that requires your arms and hands. Using LED and microchip technology, creating a strobe light seduction with your movements. Light shows, an intimate and personal experience with the clever, showcasing their moves and tricks and colorful design. Loving, slowly rising to pop culture from once a subculture. Clevers use it as a form of artistic expression of who they are, like a painter and their canvas. This is their story. This is their show.
Loving is an expression of the music. It makes you feel a certain way. You know, if you're in the crowd watching a DJ, it sort of enhances that. And as a Glover, I like to create a light show that matches the same energy that you get from the music. So you're seeing a visual representation and an audio representation of the same energy. So there's a bunch of different styles of gloving, and I won't go too deep into every single one. The main categories of different styles. You've got flow. Liquid falls under this category. Moving, your hands are chasing each other. It's about expressing liquid between things, using your fingers and a roll like this. There's tech, which is much more, you're doing everything at 90 degree angles, smaller motions with your hands and fingers, a lot more technical is where the term tech comes from. Expanded version of tech called tutting, and that's where you're using very big right angles and moving in very large motions. My main style of gloving, big inspiration is hitting the music well. It doesn't necessarily matter what move you're doing, as long as you're hitting the beats perfectly and portraying it. What I really like to do when I'm giving a light show is I'll switch in between cause and effect movements, but then I'll also add certain aspects of flow, whipping something up and around while keeping the same tech structure. So having one hand over the other, one hand comes down, the other, like this finger right here, is reacting to it. Favor tech, so more of the precise, meticulous, small motions, and trying to balance in between tech and flow to make it, trying to get an even sort of being able to use flow when I need to, when the song dictates, or go into a tutting sequence when the song dictates, to really make it come together. What does gloving mean to me? It's a way of expressing my own emotion through a song and providing the same feeling to somebody else. But when I think about gloving and what it's really done for me is it's provided a sense of community. I'm very lucky to have the opportunity to put on shows or put on events where, 50 people to 100 people show up. That's incredible to me, to have that sort of community response. The community come together around this art form and watching friendships blossom that, people who met at our events are now becoming friends outside of gloving too. And just having a real big support group, if something happens to one of our guys got his gloves stolen, everyone pitched in to get him a new set. So, for me at least, the community is the most important thing to me, and it's really had a big impact on my life. Most people view gloving as a rave afterthought, sort of people glove at raves, and that's usually the reaction I get when I tell someone I'm a glover. Gloving has had a bad rep with EDM festivals. Companies like Insomniac have banned gloving from shows. Not all festivals do this, but it's, a lot of people, like when I first looked at gloving, I thought it was just people waving their hands, moving lights, and people are on all sorts of things, just getting fucked up from the lights.
Society sees it as a drug-induced activity of those receiving a light show. With gloving comes a huge speculation, either as a drug affiliation or performance art.
Being considered an art form, there's actual moves and techniques that people study and try and perfect. And there's a real art behind matching your energy to music and really portraying that in a physical sense. It's also blossoming as a hybrid between a sport where it's live, but also like an e-sport where, you know, it's online, devoted to just the art of the light show and progressing and pushing yourself further, doing new stuff, teaching more people how to do new things. So it's really blossomed to its own. And it's still fun to go to shows and give light shows to attendees, but at least for me, it's more fun to trade concepts and really understand. You know, I'm not trying to just give other people shows. I want them to give me shows so that we can like learn from each other. And the competition has really pushed people. It's really pushed me to become better at perfecting my art. But there's definitely a different style between when I'm doing a video because I really like a song and I want to portray it, versus doing a video that's chosen by the tournament organization, and you're having to adapt to that song. What got me into gloving, I think I can trace it back to two people. Matt Whitaker, his style captivated me right away. The second person, her name's Victoria. She was just picking up gloving at the same time. Two homies learning it together from Matt, who is the more experienced one. And not thought highly of gloving because I thought it was sloppy to some certain extent. Matt really opened my eyes to it. I had a friend who was learning with me, and so it was just really fun to challenge each other to get better. And later on, Victoria, Matt, and I would found a club at UC Davis called Ambience. I owe all of my